سبحان الله عما يشركون.
It's our last day in Medina Munawwara. Last day of Medina Munawwara. Last day with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Remember, there was also a last day of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on this earth. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was ill. He was ill for about 14 days. 14 days. And on that Thursday when he became ill, he prayed Maghrib Salah. And after performing Maghrib Salah, he kept on, he performed his wudu for Isha Salah. And then he fainted. So they waited for him. The azan was done. People were waiting in the masjid. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam woke up and he said, Salah. He said, no, they're still waiting for you. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did wudu. But again, he fainted. 3, 4, 5 times he fainted. And then he said to Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala, tell Abu Bakr Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala to lead the salah. He couldn't make it. The next day, Fajr, Friday, Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala is making azan. Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala is saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. But he does not see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam coming. And he can't continue. With difficulty he finishes that azan. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not come out that Friday. 17 salah Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala led. And then on that Monday morning, it was Fajr time, as Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was leading the prayer. Just imagine how they felt. The last day Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with them. And we are with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the last day. As Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala is praying Fajr Salah. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam opened the curtain to look at his companions. And he was so happy to see them in this condition that now I have fulfilled my mission. And he was smiling, his smile was beaming. The hadith mentions his smile was beaming so much. And the companions, through the corner of their eye, they saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he was allowed to move back. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, you stay there. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam couldn't make it to the musalla, but he was so happy, and then he closed the curtain. Everyone after Fajr Salah was so happy because they thought now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is better. And after Fajr, everyone went to meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala took permission. He says, I want to go meet my family outside the outskirts of Medina Munawwara, and now you are feeling better, I want to go there. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala went somewhere. Everybody went somewhere. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the death started to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam around 10 o'clock in the afternoon. And Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha was there, and her brother came in, and he had a miswak in his hand. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, pointing towards the miswak, and she asked, do you want the miswak? He said, yes. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, put the miswak in the water, and she did the miswak for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And after doing the miswak for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started reading, Allahumma bir rafiqin a'la, Allahumma fir rafiqin a'la. And then they knew that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going, and he had his head on the chest of Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left this world. The news spread in Medina Munawwara. Everyone lost their senses. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was the greatest and the most bravest of the companions, he came to the masjid and he said, who said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has passed away? Just like Musa alayhi salatu wa salam went to the mountain to get the Torah, similarly my Prophet has come to get the Torah. 40 days he's gone, he'll come back. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu fainted in the masjid. Hazrat Usman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala anhu was lost. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu was away outside Medina. He got the news, he came rushing, he tied his camel outside the door which we go out of, Bab Jibreel, and then he went inside. He took permission to enter. The wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were in the house. They all covered themselves except Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was the daughter. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu came in, and he lifted the veil of the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he kissed the forehead of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, O Prophet of Allah, whilst you are alive, you are the best person, and whilst you have died, you are the best person. He then went into the masjid. And he saw this chaos, and he saw this confusion, and he saw Umar. And he told Umar, Umar, sit down. And he said, no, I can't sit down. Whoever says that my Prophet has passed away, he tell him to come here so that I can make their children orphans. So that I can make their children orphans. And then Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he climbed the minbar and he gave a khutbah and he read the verses, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ انْقَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبْ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا. That وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ. Yes, our messenger is our beloved and he should be our most beloved. He is the best of creation, but he is only a messenger. وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Other messengers have come before him. قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. If he dies, are you going to turn away from the deen? And Umar radiallahu ta'ala who heard these verses and it reminded him of the verse which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed before, and that's when he sat down. Today, on that day, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was no longer in front of the eyes of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Tomorrow, the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will no longer be in front of our eyes. But there will be one day when you and I will go into the grave. Each and every one of us. This life is nothing. This life is nothing. It's total clay. We are in this bubble that sometimes we forget the real life when we go into that grave. And all our family will be crying. But then when they go away, we will be left alone. And then the angels will come and they will ask the question, what is your deen? What is your deen? Ma deenuk? And then they will ask, who is your Allah? Man Rabbuk? And then they will ask the question, and this has been described in many ways, and one of the ways is that it's been described that the veils that are between you and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will all be opened up. Will all be opened up in the grave, and you will see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Tomorrow you will not no longer see the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when you go in the grave, you will see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the angels will ask, "Do you know who this is?" And all those of us who follow the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who had the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who created the love, who developed the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they will be able to say, "I know who this is. I know who this is. This is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam." And the only reason, although you have not seen him, but you long to see him, that is why you will be able to give that answer that this is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the Rasul of Allah. He is the last messenger that was sent on this earth. I know who this is. And because of your answers being correct, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors of Jannah. Allah will. The winds of Jannah will start blowing into your grave. Today, we have this last opportunity to develop the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Go to the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Go and give salams with utmost humility, with utmost love. Ask forgiveness from Allah that, oh Allah, we have spent so many years, but when we are away from here, we do not even think of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We do not even think of his sunnah. How many times, how many days have passed when we have not read durood on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Oh Allah, forgive us. Oh Prophet of Allah, we are here to ask that Allah makes you someone who will intercede for us on the day of judgment. We need his intercession, but intercession will not come easily. As I mentioned recently, there are 3 million people in Hajj, and when you are going round doing tawaf and you want to get to the Hajj Aswad, you can't get to the Hajj Aswad because there are too many people there. Then on the day of judgment, what do you think about the billions of people from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the day of judgment who will be part of his ummah? How many people will be more closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam than us? Will we be even able to see him? Because we haven't developed that love. Only those people will be close to him who have developed the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is our last day. Make the most of our last day. Cry in front of Allah. Ask for the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Follow the sunnah. Make a promise to Allah that, oh Allah, from now on, every single sunnah I learn, I will follow. When I go home, every single day, I will read at least 40 durood sharif, 100 durood sharif on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That will be part and parcel of my life. That will be part of my timetable. Yes, I might have to go to work at 7 o'clock and come back at 7 o'clock. But as part of my timetable, my love for Allah, my love for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam should be a priority. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to develop the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the deep love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just like with Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, he couldn't live in Medina. He said, I can't live in Medina. And then once he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his dream, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Oh Bilal, where are you? I'm waiting for you. And he left, he was thousands of miles away. He left on his camel the next day, and he came to visit the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw him in a dream. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam longed to see him. He came, and the grandsons Hassan and Hussein said, Bilal, you are here. We want you to give azan. The next salah, Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala, he is the one who gave azan. And the whole Medina came out, all of them crying because they remember the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And again, when Bilal came to Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, he was flowing in tears. And then he left Medina straight away because he could not bear staying in Medina without the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And here we are. Our lives are engrossed in the world, and then we forget that there will be another world where the only human being that is going to benefit us is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Only human being. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me the love. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us even a fraction of the love that the companions had. Even a little bit of that love, inshallah, will be enough for us. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.